Hello, hi everybody, this is Thekla Petridou. Today it's Friday the 18th of September 2020 and this is our weekly video in English. Today the subject is about older parents and how we deal with them as the adult children when they are difficult to handle. As you already know, I receive hundreds of emails every month from people sharing their stories with me. A very common subject in those stories is the difficulty to deal and or cope with older parents that they are, let me use the adjective I usually use, undiagnosed people. People with maybe one or maybe more personality disorders, people who are not easy to communicate with, and people who are not easy to cope with. One of the of life's more injustice things is where you are born, in which family you are born. Me as a psychologist, I have the strong opinion, that many people who are not suitable for parenting become parents. This is not a nowadays phenomenon. I think this has always been the case. To be a parent in modern times, it does not require only physical abilities. It also requires mental, spiritual, psychological abilities. Primitive people, they just needed to be fertile. They just needed to be in a position to give birth to a child and in a position to feed the child until the child could feed themselves. Nowadays, human race has evolved and there are a lot of things that a parent should take care of and should be able to care of when bringing their children up. Sadly, many parents are not very parenting. Their parenting style is not a healthy one. Many children who are born and raised in dysfunctional families that were made by a couple of undiagnosed individuals managed to survive their childhood. We have a lot of survivors in this world, and especially on our YouTube channel that we are something like 46,000 subscribers and 100,000 people visiting the videos on a monthly basis, on a daily basis, and commenting underneath the videos, especially the videos in Greek. Videos in English, it's a new category that we really hope that it will take up and more people find out about our videos and watch videos in English as well. In this community, we have many people who are survivors, many people who endured psychological, emotional abuse during their childhood by parents that were not suitable, they were not fit for parenting. These children managed to survive because of their personal struggle, because of their resilience and their true will to live a happy and healthy life. And so you go on in life and you're like 20 years old, 25 years old, 30 years old, 35 years old, 40 years old, 45 years old. You manage to build yourself, you manage to self-nurture yourself, and usually you take aid from a psychologist, either through the psychotherapy or psychoeducation. Psychoeducation, psychological education is what we do here on our channel. You read books, you make friendships with people who have similar interests, who are interested in developing emotionally, mentally, spiritually, and you manage to build your own world that is very different, so very different from your family's world. I have seen a lot of people through my office or on Skype sessions that are in their early 20s and they are so much different like their parents. They might have a parent who is not so reliable, who is not so responsible, a parent who is self-obsessed, or a set of parents who are self-obsessed, self-obsessed and with their relationship. Children and young adults who have been brought up in a war zone, in a psychological war zone in their house, in their family home, where parents were fighting, parents might be distant from each other, they might have Cold War situation, psychological warfare, cheating, violence, and so on. And I've seen those young people that they say, I'm so different than my family. I'm so different than my mother. I'm so different than my father. I don't understand why I was born in this family. These people are people with a strong will to survive and people who took their fate in their own hands and try to create their future. And when these dysfunctional parents or undiagnosed parents grow older, they might be like 60 years old and their child might be like 30 years old, or they might be like 70 years old and their child might be around 40 years old. Usually, they tend to their most sensitive child. If they have several children, they will tend to the most sensitive or the most parentified child to ask for emotional support. And you have this situation. I've read many emails from middle-aged people like myself who are in an unethical dilemma, and they say, I was brought up in a dysfunctional family setting. My father, my mother, or both my parents have difficulties with their personality. Most of you describe your parents as narcissists, but I've said again in a relevant video that me as a psychologist, I cannot use the word narcissist so lightly, and instead I use the word undiagnosed person, a person with one or multiple personality disorders that has not been diagnosed. And we understand from their behavior that they are being manipulative, they are being egocentric, they are being too selfish. They feel that the world revolves around them, and they ask from their children to support them emotionally, sometimes even financially, but mostly emotionally. They ask from their children to give them consultation on how to deal with their lives. They call their children and they say, I've had a fight with your father, and your father did this to me, and your father did that to me. I had a fight with your mother said this, your mother said that. Please, I need you to stand by me. Stand by you. I am not your parent, I'm your child. I might be an adult now, but we don't change the nature of the relationship. You are still the one who decided to bring me in this world. You are still the one who took this huge responsibility of giving birth to another human being and giving education and psychological education, spiritual education and emotional education to a new person entering the society. You failed to do so. You failed to do so because you are a child yourself. You are self-centered yourself. You are not mature enough yourself. You are too involved in your own drama, being a drama queen, because most of these parents are also very dramatic. They act like drama queens. And most possibly, if they get diagnosed, they might have the diagnosis of histrionic personality disorder. That's why I say maybe a couple of disorders, because clinical experience has shown that most people get a bunch of diagnoses of personality disorders, mostly of cluster B. Cluster B personality disorders include narcissistic personality disorder, antisocial personality disorder, histrionic personality disorder, and so on. By saying this, I do not mean that if somebody has willingly been to a psychologist's office or a psychiatrist's office, and they have taken a clinical evaluation, and they have the diagnosis of having any kind of personality disorder, and these people are willing to work with themselves, are willing to go into psychotherapy and try to make themselves more functional, that these people are not gonna change. But the thing with undiagnosed people or toxic parents, I would say, in this instance, is that they do not realize that they have a problem. They feel that they are the victims of a very bad life. They cry about themselves. They say, oh, I've had such a bad life and I didn't have a good childhood and everything goes wrong to me and my luck is bad and it's not working for me and I had a bad husband, I had a bad wife, my job was not good enough, I didn't win the lottery, I didn't have success without working, blah, 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 blah. Those parents, they tend to come to their adult children, the successful ones, the survivor ones, and ask for emotional support and manipulate them into being their endless psychological assistants. Because if a person does not realize their situation and they do not take responsibility of their own actions, when they turn to other people for support, they just want to suck off energy from other people. I understand that being a child and being a responsible adult and being a person with empathy and a spiritual person, you really want to help your parent. You really want to assist them in their emotional difficulties. You feel like that you have a moral obligation to be by your parents, to be there for them, even though they did not do that for you. And most of the times, these parents that are manipulative, as I said earlier, they use money or material stuff in order to say, I gave you so much money, I gave you good education, I gave you some property, I took you to the best schools, I bought the best clothes for you, I was there for you, you should be there for me now. And they exchange material givings for emotional givings. I have this opinion and I want to share it with you. And I have this opinion being a parent myself. I have two young adult children. My son is 23 years old and my daughter is 20 years old. My children do not owe me anything. They don't owe me anything. I owe them. I owed them to take care of them when they were underage. I owed them to be careful during my pregnancies in order to give them health and physical health and emotional health. I had the responsibility to pay for their education, to pay for their clothing, to cook for them, to take care of them, to take them to the doctor. I had that obligation because I decided to become a parent. They did not decide to be my children. I decided for them. I decided for them to bring them in this world, which is not such a such an easy place most of the time. I speak to you not only as a psychologist, but also as a parent. Our children do not owe us anything. We do not owe anything to our older parents if we are an adult. By this, I don't mean to be inhumane. And if our parent is in a difficult health situation, we don't give our assistance. Or if they are in a very difficult financial situation, we don't help them. What I'm worried about is about the emotional drainage that can happen if an adult survivor child plays the role of the psychological supporter of their undiagnosed elder parents. I will tell you this tip, which I learned in university. While I think it was on a workshop about family therapy, systemic family therapy, and our instructor, who was a very mature and good systemic psychological therapist, told us this truth, which is a universal truth for therapists, that if you have some people malfunctioning, either those people are your clients or your parents in this case, and they ask for you to go in and help them, if you go in and help them, things might become worse because they feel that they do not have any responsibility anymore. Their savior has arrived. Their responsible child has arrived, who's going to take care of everything, and they let themselves without trying to do something. And in the situation that you deny help, you say, I'm sorry, mother, I'm sorry, father, I'm sorry, mom, I'm sorry, dad, I'm 45 years old, I'm 40 years old, I'm 35 years old, I have my own family, I have my own relationship, I have my own life. I cannot come like a firefighter every 2 or 3 days to help you get out of the fight with my father or with my mother. I cannot be your referee. I cannot be the person that takes care of your emotional stability. You are an adult. You should be responsible for yourself. If you need anything, if you need psychological support, please go to a therapist. Go to a psychologist. Start therapy. Take professional help. I'm your child. I'm not a free psychologist or a free psychotherapist. Deny your parents to act as referees in their fights or to become their free psychotherapist or psychologist. Deny this. Deny this. Put limits. Show with assertiveness that you really love them and you really care for them, but you cannot be there and do the work for them. You could tell them, I have to make sacrifices in my own personal life in order to improve my own personal life. I have to try hard in order to keep my work. I need to try hard in order to keep my relationship or to be a good parent to my own children, your grandchildren that you don't care about. And think about it. They have grandchildren and sometimes great-grandchildren, and they act as more childish than their children, their grandchildren or great-grandchildren. There are so many of them. So many little selfish older people who try to rely on their children for emotional support. Not all parents are like this. I'm very blessed to have two very responsible parents. My mother is 74 years old. My father is 71. They are both very responsible people. All my life, I remember them handling their businesses, handling their emotional issues between themselves. I always remember them to have solutions for their problems. My parents are very religious. My father is a priest. They didn't go to a psychologist. They went to a priest to confess and talk about their relationship. But they had somebody outside of their marriage, not their children, to be there for them when they needed emotional or spiritual support. They also are very careful with their health. They go by themselves and visit their doctors. They do their annual checkups. They take care of their health. Never, never have I had any call from my parents for me to assist them. Many times, and especially in the past when I was younger, I would call my parents because most of the time I live abroad. I don't live in the same place as my parents. I live in another town, another city, or in another country. And many times, especially when I was under 30, I would call my mother, I would call my father, and ask for their consultation. I would say, I'm in this difficult situation. What would you think? And my parents were very willing to talk to me as an adult to an adult and trying to give me their insight. But they never asked for my insight. And this is a good thing because they know their position. They know that they are parents and I'm a child, even though we are all both older than the time I was a 3 year old and we were like 30 years old. The same thing, I try hard to exercise with my children. I do not want them to worry about me. I do not want them to take any responsibility for me. I do not want them to feel that they owe me to keep company to me, to be my friends, to be somebody who would give me emotional, psychological support. No, this is not what children are for. Emotional, psychological support you get from your therapist. You get from your peers. You get from your friends. You get from your partner if you have a partner. You get from yourself if you have spirituality. You try by yourself to solve your own issues. Being lightweight, emotionally and spiritually lightweight, is a big, big, huge psychological success. I take care of my business, you take care of your business, and when we meet, the adult child and the older parent, we hang out like two people who love each other, that they have strong blood bond, but nobody is responsible for one another. It's a totally different thing to have an older parent who has a bad health and they are at the end of their lives and to comfort them. If your parent has cancer or they have a fatal disease or they are very, very old and they are afraid of death or they are in a situation that it's so human, it's so natural to feel like, I will go and see my mother, I'll see my father, I will stay by their bed, I will give them reassurance, I will give them comfort, I will show them my love because I love them, because they've been good parents, because they are in my life, they were in my life, they had the role they used to have. Respect is not demanded. Respect is earned. It's earned by responsibility. I know that religion and culture tell us that you should respect your parents, no matter what. I totally disagree with that. You cannot respect a parent who is neglectful. You cannot respect a parent who is self-obsessed. You cannot respect a parent who is not taking responsibility of themselves and they try to impose themselves on their children. You cannot respect them. You can love them, meaning being connected with them because there is also the blood bond, but you cannot respect them. Not respecting somebody doesn't mean to show disrespect in saying bad words or cursing them or wishing them bad wishes. No, you have a realistic view of your parent. My parent is an older child. My parent is spoiled. My parent is egocentric. My parent is self-centered. I'm really sorry, but my parents should grow up. And I, since I'm not their parent, I cannot help them grow up. So no remorse, no guilt over denying our older parents to become their psychological assistants and their psychiatric nurses and people that they will lean on in order not to take care of their responsibilities, not to solve their own problems, but somebody to be there in order to take their emotional burden and essentially use him. Don't allow your older parents to use you. Don't allow them to manipulate you. Don't allow them to guilt trip you. Know who you are. Know your limits. Know that your responsibilities are not what they might trying to tell you that they are. I cannot tell you not to love your parents because I think it's only very natural to love your parents. And in very rare cases that the parent is very abusive and in very bad ways, you can feel that I cannot love this person. Even parentified children, even abused children, when they grow up and they are survivors, they still feel love and care for their parents. But don't allow them to guilt trip you into becoming somebody that they take their temper on, somebody that takes care of their issues while they remain irresponsible and immature. I think it's time for our parents also to mature, not just us. I wish you the best. Have a nice weekend, everybody. Bye. See you next Friday with a new video in English.